Hey, good morning, good morning. This is Israel Wendy. Hey. Welcome replay viewers, welcome Facebook, welcome WhatsApp to this replay, and welcome those who are coming in. I'm just going to quickly show you the temperature of upstate New York or central New York. All you do is you look on the map and you see New York and you see all those lakes that look like fingers. Well, I live between two of those fingers. So, anyway, I have the comments that only people that I follow can comment, because a lot of this scope I will be painting and I will not be able to see your comments. So I apologize for that. I thank you ahead of time for the hearts, the shares, and the tweets. And I love you guys. I love you guys. I love you guys to pieces. So I'm going to start out showing you the temperature, then we'll get into painting. And I do want to say that tomorrow is Gospel Day. Today's Monday. So tomorrow on Tuesday, I always play gospel music. It's spirited music. And I'm thinking about doing another Kat Ello scope using her music, because when I watch your guys' scopes, the Jesus Did It group, and when I watch your guys' scope, I sit on my couch, kick back, I take my glasses off, and sometimes when I'm tapping out those hearts, I accidentally unfollow you guys. And I apologize, but when you unfollow somebody, hey John, how are you? Good morning. When I accidentally unfollow people, then I lose all, like, I've been number one super fan for a lot of people, and I've lost it because I've accidentally unfollowed you. So don't feel bad if you, hey, all of a sudden I've unfollowed you. It's me, because like I said, I take my glasses off and I tap the hearts, and that's what happens. So anyway, I'm quickly going to show you the thank you for the hearts. I'm put up some emojis. Follow this guy. He has some cool scopes. And like I said, follow John Morrow. Sounds like he's a good Italian. But anyway, so I'm going to show you the temperature. There we go. Yeah, follow him. He's got good scopes. He's got good. And that's the temperature for today. Not much going on in the weather. But anyway, I just wanted to show you. Hey, 46. Anyway, I wanted to show you one of the shirts from the Jesus Did It group, and you can go on their website. It's jesusdidit.org, and they have really nice stuff on there. They got stickers, they got cups, they got a lot of different stuff. They have t-shirts and all kinds of stuff, hoodies. And the one that I got, I bought an extra large. And I thought, well, I'll get an extra large and I can give it away because it won't fit me. I thought, well, I'll probably need a 2 or 3X. But anyway, this fits me perfect. So beware that these may be a little big. T-shirts. I think they're in men's sizes. So I'll just give you a peek at one of them here. And this is what it says. And you might want to take a picture of this. It tells you what your identity is in Christ. And let me just fix the bottom here so you can see the www.jesusdidit.org. So this is a cool thing, what your identity in Christ. And this is the back, and I'm sorry, I got fuzzies on it. I washed it with a fuzzy blanket, and I didn't realize it was in there. So I'm sorry, this is a bad representation because I should have got the lint brush out. But this is what it looks like on the front. It is so awesome. And I do want to get the mug because I drink a lot of coffee and I go through a lot of, I drink tea as well. But this is what this is. It's pretty awesome. So anyway, let's get started painting. And like I said, if I'm not following you, you probably can't comment because I'm not going to be able to see you. And I don't know if I should move my, let's move this forward just a little bit here. So that, and we're going to start with the worship music. Yes. Well, on your way to work, you can listen to the worship music here. I got to get like a whiteboard to put behind there. Oh, if I pull myself any farther forward here, I'm going to lose the space for my paintbrush and my water and stuff like that. Anyway, I already started. I kind of did like another sunrise because I have a calendar that has all these awesome sunrises on it. So I'm just kind of emulating them. And I started, I like bright colors, so I got the oranges, but I left a spot there for the sun, because I'm going to paint in the sun in that area. So God bless you guys. I'm sorry if I miss your comments, because I'm going to be painting. So enjoy the music, and as you're coming in, God bless you all. Praise God. So here we go. Let's find some good music. I downloaded some new stuff here. I downloaded something by Hillside Young and Free. I guess there's more kinds of hill songs than I know, but let's see. Okay. This is called Sinking Deep by Hillsong Young and Free. And I just downloaded this yesterday, so enjoy, enjoy. God bless you guys. Welcome to the broadcast. I'm using some primary yellow here. And I finally got my white. The titanium white. I don't think I'm going to run out for a long time. That's a lot of white. But I'm going to use up my little ones first. God bless you guys for coming in and watching the scope. Share to your friends. I'm sorry if you can't comment because I'm not following you, but I can't see all the comments when I'm painting. Turn it a little bit so you can see it better. My We'll start here in the center here with the sun. I'm not good at doing a perfect circle here, but God bless your day. Thank you for joining the broadcast. Oh, I'm painting my new little stand here. Well, it's unfinished. It needs to be painted anyway. And again, I'm using basically primary colors and mixing them for, I love bright colors. As we get closer, it's going to get even brighter. Don't look at the sun, people, because it's not good to look at the sun. You know, I got a great idea this morning. There's a something right there. Probably a doggy here. Well, it's in the painting now. Now, how did a sex bot get in there? I don't understand how a sex bot got in there when I limited the chat. That is crazy. That just goes to show you that I wouldn't go to that website that they promote, because it may be full of viruses and all kinds of hacking stuff. Gotta cover that up right there. Well, I'll let this dry and then I'll put a little more paint on it right there. Yeah. is kind of like the sunlight shining down. Praise God that we have sunlight, and you know, the way God created everything, it's just so perfect. We have the perfect climate, the perfect everything for life on this planet, and it was all because of the purpose of God. I mean, it's incredible. And for those of you that don't believe in God, to just look up in the sky at the sun, I mean, that didn't just happen. Now, this is a song that I first heard on a scope by Rick Costa. If you are not familiar with the Jesus Did It family, just hashtag Jesus Did It, and you will find a whole group of people that do nice Christian scopes. Anyway, Rick Costa is the founder of the Jesus Did It group. So I would encourage you to check out his scopes. And you will see why he's the founder and the VIP of the group. I'm going to let that dry a little bit. It's funny, right where I live, it's nice and sunny, but I look over towards my neighbor and it's dark. There is quite a darkness there. Now, I spent some money on some brush cleaners. I'm going to clean these brushes up a little bit. And boy, does it smell good, that brush cleaner. Wow. I did a scope yesterday where I sang a song, and poured my heart out. I hope you guys catch that. I posted it on Facebook and WhatsApp. This is what I'm using here. I don't know if you can see it, but it's acrylic paint. And this is Diaxazine Purple that I'm going to be using. And that's what this color is down here. Diaxazine Purple acrylic paint, and I'm going to be adding black to it. If I can find my black, I bought a big one, but I want to use up all the little ones I got before I'm going to be using ivory black with it. Praise God, praise God, praise God. Thank you for your hearts. Thank you for your shares. Thank you for your tweets. I appreciate you guys. I gotta check out my brushes here. I should have had them laying out. Found a brush that is stiff. That's not good. Too bad, because that's the one I wanted to use. No, I'll put it in the cleaner. This is the brush cleaner I'm using. It's called the Masters Brush Cleaner and Preservative. The Masters. And since this scope is God's scope, and because we are adored, blessed, and loved by our Creator, Jesus Christ, and the Father God and the Holy Spirit all in one. Because we are His children, He loves us. And He is the author of this scope, this painting, because I've only been painting since the end of February. And I have no formal training, no nothing. And it's all the Holy Spirit working through me. Jesus is amazing, the things they can do. And I'm going to do this song. I don't know if this is too rock and roll for you guys, but I like this song. God's always there with us. Hey, God bless you, Jason. Welcome. Welcome, everybody. Good morning. Good morning, Galatians. I'm not sure of your real name. God bless you today. I hope you can hear the music, because Michelle, oh, that's a pretty name. Well, thank you for coming to the scope. Thank you for inviting followers and the hearts, and you guys are incredible. Yeah, these are members of the Jesus Did It group too. Such a wonderful group. I was just telling earlier how I feel bad because I keep unfriending or unfollowing Rick. So I don't think I'm ever going to be on his super fan list. Because I sit down and I take my glasses off and I tap hearts, and a lot of times I accidentally unfollow people. So it's not you guys if I do it to you. It's me. And I did it to Kat Ello, but I, you know, it's crazy. They should have a thing that asks you, are you sure you want to unfollow? But okay, we're gonna put a landscape in here, and it's gonna be dark. It's gonna be like a hill right here, and this brush for some reason is pretty stiff. I don't know why. I got a new package of paint brushes. This is gonna be like a hill here. Yes, God is here with us all the time. He loves us. There is so many things that we have been blessed by. Do you guys have any good testimonies how God has blessed you? I mean, I have a ton of them. Things that God has done that is incredible. All right, we'll go down into there. I mean, God restored my, I had a hearing disability. God has done so much. God has done so much for me. And yes, there are miracles these days. I think I'll round this hill out a little bit more there. Water this down so that it blends in a little here. Lord, I need you. Oh, I need you. Every hour I need you. My one defense, my righteousness. I'm going to put a little bit of water in there. God is my all in all. Yeah, so many times in our lives, God has done so much. I don't think I would be alive today if it wasn't for God and the Holy Spirit leading. And even when I wasn't a Christian, things happened to me that I just can't explain, other than God had his hand on me, even when I wasn't believing in him. Oh God, how I need you. I mean, here I am on disability, just barely going through, and God brought, provided me. I was able to get a new phone. I'm able to get the supplies for my painting, because I got so much money back on my taxes that I'm rounding this off here. I don't know how people do it without him. I really don't. What do they put their hopes in? Men? Men are fallible. God bless. God bless you. I never know what I'm going to paint. I just start and it comes to me. The Holy Spirit leads me. I'm going to make this kind of bumpy here because landscape is not smooth as glass except for water. I had an idea this morning. My uncle is a professional painter. I should get some advice from him. Yeah, it kind of looks like the lakes around me. I've gone through 8 brushes already. Okay. Let's see. I'm trying to let... Well, the lake is dry, so I can do some painting on the lake. I just randomly pick music, I don't know. This is Elevation Worship. I can't believe that the sex bots are getting in here. Because I thought I restricted the chat to only people I follow, and I certainly don't follow any sex bots. Yes, please don't look in your past. Look to the future. Because God has a good future for you. Fix your eyes on Jesus. Thank you for the hearts, Michelle. Thank you so much. I don't have too many hearts. But I have a big heart right here. And it's because of the love of Jesus Christ. Reflecting some of the color off of the sky here. And yes, I'm painting with both hands. I'm literally a left-hander that has had to learn to do things right-handed because I had surgery on my left hand to take a little bit of arthritis out of there. And ended up with my hand being almost paralyzed, and I was at a conference and the Holy Spirit kept telling me, open your palm, open it up, open your hand up. And I'm like, I can't. And when I did, there was gold dust in the creases, and I was able to open my hand after that. So I've had so many miracles in my life. I believe what I've seen so many miracles. This is called Here's My Heart, Lord by Lauren Daigle. And we got waves coming in here. Whoop, it's starting to dry. Put a little more color in here for the sun on the little more sunlight on our there's our reflection there from the sun. So looks better when I use both hands, not just the one. I'm all out of square brushes here. That's too bad. One last song, and we'll honor the Holy Spirit in this song. And God bless your day. He'll bring blessings your way, I'm sure of it.
Tasted and seen of the sweet.
God bless you. Thank you for joining the scope, Michelle. Thank you, all you replay viewers. God bless your day. I hope that you can go forward and remember just there I am. Just remember that you are adored, you are blessed, and you are loved by God. There is no one that is more proud of you than God. He loves you because you are wonderfully made, and that love is unconditional. You're my number two Superman. Well, God bless you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Michelle. Thank you so much. So, God loves you. Just remember that. You are wonderfully and fearfully made. He loves you. He loves you. He wants to know everything that you are doing. He wants to be involved with everything. So talk with him. Talk with him because he really cares. God loves you. He's not the big, scary, Zeus-like, lightning bolt kind of God up there. You are not going to collapse a church if you walk into the church. No. God loves you, and he wants to forgive you. He wants to unburden you from all your burdens, all your worries. God gives you peace. He gives you rest. And he takes away that anxiety because he gives you hope. And in this crazy world that we're living in, especially here in the United States, we need that hope. And we need his love. And there's no love like the love of God. God's love is unconditional. He will never leave you, never forsake you. And he wants you to believe in him. And oh my goodness, I got paint on this phone. How did I do that? I got orange paint on it. Well, anyway, so God bless your day. And I'm glad that you joined. Thank you for the hearts. Thank you for the shares. Facebook, thank you for joining. WhatsApp, thank you. Periscope, Twitter. Whatever social media that you are watching this on, I bless you with the blessings from God. God wants to bless you today. And when I say blessings to you, I mean it. I want everyone to experience that love of God. Because I do love you guys. I love you. And I wouldn't want even my worst enemy, if I had any, to experience that hellfire. I just recently watched a documentary where they were looking for Sodom and Gomorrah, and they literally found these, you know, some of them were this big, some of them were this big. They found brimstone. And when they lit that, they lit a little teeny one. I mean, it was not even the size of my thumbnail. They lit that. And they had to get out of the room because the stench was so bad. And they said they could not imagine a whole ton of them coming down on to Sodom and Gomorrah. And hell is going to be worse than that. But God doesn't want you to be there. No, he wants to give you love. He wants to pamper you. He wants to take away all the things that should not be in your life. You know, the worry, the pain, the etc. But I'm, you know, it's not a picnic being a Christian. It is a road, it's a journey. And yes, when you first start out as a baby Christian, God is wooing you. God is giving you everything that you could ever imagine. He's delivering you from your addictions. He's taking away that guilt and condemnation. You are on fire when you're a little Christian. But as you get older, God leads you and He teaches you. And through the Holy Spirit, yes, He wants to glorify, He wants to be glorified through our lives. So as a good father, He does allow things to happen. That he lets us have our free will and lets us get into these crazy situations. And they're not only, you know, these crazy situations, sometimes we are not sometimes we're just not listening to God, and God needs to get our attention. I've had that happen to me. I tell people that I was hit by a 4x4 truck. You know, I literally had an accident, and because I wasn't listening to God, I believed in Him, but here I was still drinking and still carousing and doing all these things that I shouldn't be doing. And I had a horrible truck accident. I should have died. But during the truck accident, this huge angel came to me and said, "Israel, come here." And so then I knew that my name was Israel. I knew that that's what God, you know, that's how God referred to me. So that's why I took up that name. But anyway, I was miraculously saved. You know, I was tumbling down this huge hill with my seatbelt didn't work. My airbag didn't work because the front end of the truck was ripped right off. So, you know, I could have easily died in that 4x4 accident, and God saved me and put me on a path, because I was like, what is Israel? What does that mean? And it gave me a desire to read the word. And I know there's people out there that say, "Well, how do I read the Bible?" Well, you have to pray. I know it's hard. I myself have trouble understanding the Bible. But if you meditate on it and you ask the Holy Spirit, "Holy Spirit, show me." I literally prayed for a Holy Spirit Bible study. And the Holy Spirit led me every day. Sometimes for like 2 weeks, I had the same, like two verses of the Bible. And I'm like, "Holy Spirit, I want to learn something different." But it wasn't until I got it, until I had revelation from the Holy Spirit, that the Holy Spirit released me from, you know, studying those two Bible verses. So don't be surprised if you know, you're led to read just a verse or two verses in the Bible, and the next day it might be the same thing, the same verses. But pray. You have to open communication up with the Holy Spirit. You have to open communication up. You know, how would it be if you were married? Hi, Enoch, how are you? How would it be if you were married and you never talked to your husband or your wife? What kind of a relationship would that be? I mean, even deaf people do the sign language. You know, they communicate with each other. But if you never communicated with your spouse, that would not be a relationship. It's the same with God. We need to talk with him. I mean, you can say anything to God. God's not going to be surprised. Can you imagine what a lot of people have prayed to God? I mean, I've prayed some weird things myself. You know, like I said, I prayed, Holy Spirit, can you give me a Bible study? You know, and then later on, I found out that, you know, that's probably one of the best prayers is say, hey, I want to know. I want knowledge. I want to know the truth. And the Holy Spirit will lead you on that. Boy, I have my chin. I do my chin exercises. But anyway, so God bless your day. Thank you for joining. This is Israel Wendy signing out. Hey, troops, get your armor on. Praise God. Praise God today. Make sure you're praising, 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 even in your storms. And boy, the broadcast doesn't want to stop, does it? Oh, it says my battery is low. And I can't get to the stop broadcast button. Oh, with the paint on.